Welcome to Food Talk with Sharon. Today's recipe is an all-time favorite Indian sweet. Gajar ka halwa or carrot halwa. Winter is just around the corner, and during winter time we all prefer to have something warm. And this is one sweet which tastes best when it's warm. And for me, when it's winter time, I really love preparing this with the winter carrots, those red, long and really sweet ones. But today we are using the normal orange ones, but I highly recommend you to try this recipe with the winter carrots. That makes it absolutely divine. And my mouth is watering now. So let's quickly check out the recipe. But before we do that, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And please do click that tiny bell icon too and turn on all notifications. The first step is to fry some dry fruits. So I'm using a mix of cashews, almonds and raisins here. You can always skip the almonds and raisins, but I would definitely not skip cashews in my carrot halwa. Add the cashews and almonds first and then add the raisins later. Otherwise, if you start frying all of them together, the raisins will end up burning. So once the dry fruits are all fried, take it off heat. Heat some ghee in your pan. And then add the grated carrots to it. So stir this on a medium heat till the carrots start changing their color. And you can add a little ghee in between again. Next goes in milk. Let the carrot and milk cook together till the milk evaporates. I've taken whole milk for this recipe, and once you add the milk, you need to keep stirring it in between. So it takes about half an hour for me to prepare this for this quantity. And the maximum time in that, about 15 to 20 minutes, is this step wherein the carrots and the milk are cooking together. So the milk has to be completely absorbed by the carrots before you add the sugar into this. I've started getting the aroma of the cooked carrots, and this really takes me back to my childhood. So mom used to make this during winters in large quantities, just because the three of us would fight for it after it's made. So it definitely is a time-consuming process, because the grating of carrots takes time, the cooking of this takes time, but then it's totally worth the wait. So the milk is all absorbed now, and time to add the sugar. And along with sugar, I also like to add a little bit of condensed milk. That just gives it an extra creaminess. So cook this again. So once you add the sugar and the condensed milk, it'll again release more liquid. So that